Hi, I'm Danny Whitfield.
And I'm Rhoda Whitfield. And it's time for another segment of
Marriage Takes Work.
Hello, and welcome to another segment of Marriage Takes Work. Yes, this is 2024 and the year we expect more. This year, you can expect more from us as we go deeper with our marital topics. If there's a topic you wish for us to address, stay tuned at the end of this segment to get our contact information. With that being said, we have a great topic for discussion today, along with our weekly guest, Elder Darrick, and First Lady Takiya McGhee of Bible-Based Church, Tallahassee, Florida. How are you all doing today?
Great.
Doing great.
Fantastic.
All right. Today we're talking about, can outside friendship ruin your marriage? So having friendships with individuals and other couples in many situations can be healthy for married couples. The friendships we have while married must first have a respect for marriage and a full understanding of scripture that includes the importance of cleaving to your spouse. Some friendships we bring into the marriage, some we develop within the marriage. Some friends are mutual friends of our spouse, but some friends, especially those we bring into the marriage that fail to develop a relationship with our spouse, doesn't necessarily mean they will be good for our marriage. I am a firm believer that when someone is imparting advice in your direction regarding how you should handle things as a person or speaking into your marriage, they should be coming from a spiritual place that can be supported by scripture.
That's good.
So I want to discuss that. I want to hear your thoughts on that.
Well, having friendships before marriage that are not mutual friends, I think boundaries need to be put in place.
That's good.
Because my husband won't be available for you like he was before, because he's my husband, right?
Yeah, that's right.
And then also, when you have somebody who is a friend before marriage, things come into play. Is that person married? All of that, because if that person is not married, they can influence you to do stuff that's not according or lining up with your marriage. So you do have to put boundaries in place,
right,
before marriage.
I agree with that. I also think when you talk about outside friendships, couples have to be careful too, because sometimes you can seek the counsel of outside friends or give them the impression that their opinion matters until going forward, they always feel like they have the right to give you an opinion or be involved in your marriage. When I do premarital counseling, when we do it, I always talk about the many shapes of marriage. And I always argue to them that the dangerous shapes are a rectangle and a square, right? If you don't think about a square, you have four equal sides. Your marriage is supposed to be you, your spouse, and God. Whenever you have that fourth person in there, it's never going to end up well. And you think about outside friendships, those individuals have either been brought in or brought themselves in, and it's a dangerous situation. If they're single, they have a different perspective on how things look. There are some people who don't accept your new situation, right? So they still want to keep you to your old ways, whatever it may be. Oftentimes, they're not, as you mentioned, Pop, they're not looking at it from a scriptural standpoint. And the toxicity they bring to that marriage is a dangerous, dangerous situation. And there are some scenarios out there where that fourth person ends up being the one trying to take or intrude on your marriage and replace you, right? You have to be very careful using a word about boundaries, putting things in place, but not just putting them in place, but also maintaining those boundaries, right? Where even you on the inside don't cross over as well, because everybody is not happy about you being happy.
That's right. Correct. Right. Oh, that's good.
You know, I would say this. A lot of times we have a tendency to think that some people think that things should stay as they are. You know, like you get married, you had a single friend, and they think that because you used to do these things when you as a couple were dating, that you still can do it. But now you are in a marriage with your spouse, and that's your primary concern now. But some people don't want that. We have to be careful about who we allow to sit in our marriage. Yes, sometimes we have to be straight up and tell them, listen, I need to vent, but I don't want you to say nothing. I don't want you to say nothing. I just need to be able to get this out. The minute you allow somebody to impart into the conversation that you're having, you're inviting them into your marriage. Yeah. And every time you look, they're going to have something to insert. And it's going to cause friction, especially if it was a friend that was not a mutual friend between the two of you.
Yeah.
If it was just either or, they're going to have something. If they got a problem with your spouse, they're going to have something to say. Mm-hmm. Always. Well, see, if I was you, I just wouldn't. I don't want to hear what you wouldn't have done. And then if they've been married multiple times, I really don't want to hear what they got to say.
They're not an authority.
Come on now.
They're not an authority.
I don't want to hear what they got to say.
But like you, Derek, I talking to couples, I stress so much how important it is to not to take that outside stuff that come, you know, get that folk get in your ear, that it affects your relationship with your spouse.
Yep.
Don't accept it. If folk come to, if you're gonna get some advice, if it's not coming from the word, if it ain't coming there, I don't want it. I'm not accepting. Like Rhoda said, when it happens or when you're giving feedback, it's got to be scriptural. It's just so dangerous. You got to set those boundaries, and you got to have them.
Yes.
And they got to be monitored as you go
through. There you go. There you go.
As you go through your marriages, because it's the first sign of stress or conflict, our minds immediately tell us, I'm going to go ask my ace what they think.
Mm-hmm.
Not a good place to go.
No, because see what's going to happen. You're going to go and talk to your ace, and then you're going to come home and have the mitigated gall to say, well, Derek said, Derek ain't got no business in this conversation.
Exactly. Why That's did right. you call Derek in the first
yeah.
place?
Yeah.
Okay. That part.
Let me add to that too, though, is on the other end of that is you go to that outside friend, that ace, and give some advice, or you go to them, and then all of a sudden you and your spouse reconcile. But this person you done brought in is still on 10 of anger, because when you left their presence, you were emotional and you were distraught. And so though you guys have reconciled, that person's still holding on. So now they're never going to let go of that feeling, because you invited them in. Now they're viewing your spouse differently in that regard. It's going to always be that lingering. As you mentioned, they'll always find a way to insert their opinion about something. It may not be verbal, maybe something they send in a text, right? Maybe whatever it may be, and you're going to always now be refereeing. Mm-hmm. And you got to be mindful that this person got involved because I allowed this person in. And once you let them in, they're never going to voluntarily evict themselves out. They're going to always want to have an opinion. Mm-hmm. And you got to be mindfully careful. You got to be careful about that, including sometimes it's friends who are married, but their marriages are not
what they
wanted to be. Right. So now they want to vent their venom on your marriage because they're not happy in their own marriages. Even those friends are dangerous to your marriage as well.
Yeah. That's true.
Listen, send somebody a text talking about, yeah, your husband or your wife act like they didn't see me. They didn't even want to speak. Why are you throwing that at the spouse?
Exactly. Exactly. Exactly.
So what is the spouse supposed to go do? Larry say, you didn't speak to him.
Just keeping it going. Just keeping it going.
Well, listen, what would be signs to you that your spouse friend is having a negative impact on your relationship?
Listen, especially if it's opposite sex friend, Like, if you're a damsel in distress, no.
Yeah.
I know
Because
that's right.
that is a doorway in.
Yeah, that's good.
Like, you can't figure life out. What were you doing before you met you? I'm sure you can figure life out by yourself.
Yeah, that's good. That's good.
That's one sign. Stop laughing.
Yeah.
Another sign is just like, girl, if I was you, I wouldn't take that. Like, I venting can be toxic if you're not venting to the right person. So I would say those two things.
Admittedly, I struggled at points in our marriage in this area, and not I'm not one who brings in outside voices, but the work that I do professionally, I interact with a lot of people, and it's she mentioned about the damsel piece. I try to be careful about overstepping. At the same point, when you have a heart for people, right, as a pastor, you got to be disciplined enough to realize that you're not God.
That's
All
right.
right. You got to know your role or the lack thereof and not venture over in that regard. And so one sign I think is when your spouse is trying to make you aware of said friend's influence, and you're more defensive of the friend than you are of heeding the counsel of your spouse.
Oh
Right?
boy.
Where you are arguing your spouse down in defense of that friend versus saying, you know what, maybe there is something there. The Lord bless your men. Your wife is your helpmeet. She's gonna see things you didn't see, right? You
Amen.
discern things you don't discern. If you don't heed that counsel, then that's a bad sign, because all of a sudden now that friend's having an influence over you that is dangerous to your marriage, to the communication of your marriage, and to the trust of your marriage. And it now leaves your wife vulnerably wondering, but well, what else is going on?
What's going on
Now,
between y'all?
what's going on with y'all? All of a sudden now I'm now wondering things I wasn't wondering before because of the way you're so passionate in your defense of said person. And now I'm left to wonder what's going on here. And that you got to be mindful. And sometimes that means we can be so naive that we don't pick up on the cues that I don't see her that way, but how does she see you, right? She's coming to you with every situation. Your spouse is telling you, be careful. You're like, man, stop being jealous. Hold on now. It may not be jealousy, brother. Maybe she's seeing something.
Right, right,
She's
right.
seeing something that you need to be careful of.
You know, a lot of times Kia has a tendency to say, we're not here to hurt each other. But then sometimes people can have a spouse that put more trust in their friend.
Man, that's
I
good.
don't care if it's your childhood friend. They put more trust in their friend
That's good.
than they have in their spouse. Well, why did you marry your spouse?
Supposed to be your best friend.
That's
Best
right.
friend.
And if there is anyone that you can dump on or you dump with, that's the person you want to
That's
dump.
right.
And
Good.
not that outside person who doesn't have, more times than many, your best interest in mind.
That's good.
Because it's about them. It's
Yeah.
not about you and how your marriage can keep
Right.
thriving.
Yeah,
You know,
that's
you know.
good.
And
That's
I
good.
definitely would have a problem if every time we're having a conversation, Jer, Lord, I was going to say Jared, he's dropping something that a friend said into our conversation. Well, you know, Raymond said, you know, Charlie said, are you talking about? Can't you think for yourself?
That's really, really good. That's really, really good. I like what you said about the damsel in distress, because men, we are
So blind.
yes.
So blind. And women, why? A woman knows another woman,
I
right?
was going there though. Yeah.
Like, we can see we know how we act, right?
Right,
Right,
So we
right,
know
right.
when you're putting on to get attention.
Yeah. I wasn't
And
going there, but that's good. That's
but you
good.
know, but
Fine. Like, hello, do you
yeah.
not see what's going on
What I was
here?
going to say is we have the tendency to want to be, we have a hero syndrome, right? We want to be the savior and not realizing that that damsel could be in disguise, not in
Yes.
distress, right? It'd be in
You
disguise.
got
They're
enough to
faking.
be the hero
There
for
you
in
go.
your own home.
There you go. I was going there exactly. Like you could not even see that, like you mentioned, ain't nothing wrong there. You just don't realize this is a whole disguise. You done got lured in. And the Bible talks about this in the book of Proverbs, right? About a man who get lured in and don't realize by the time he done got lured in by the woman, all of a sudden now he done got himself caught up, where now his next result is death. I'm paraphrasing the book. But because you just you got lured in because you're trying to be the hero, and it was a trap. And because you didn't heed the signs, the warnings, the counsel of your spouse, all of a sudden now you're so deeply involved in something that you can't get your way out. And now your home life that used to be
It's causing
peaceful
friction, yes.
now is full of friction, and you don't know how to get your way out. Now you're trying to balance both ends. Like, I have a hard time when I hear people say, "This is my work spouse." Like, phrases like that really frustrate me because I know what it means when I say this is my spouse. So when you add the word work in there, then you that adding the word work to the word spouse doesn't make it right.
That's
If
right.
anything, it's dangerous because now you're engaging this person in conversations about your marriage that could be used against you later on. So
Work spouse, you're giving them all rights and privileges to be your spouse, but just during the day.
you own it tonight. Go
Like,
ahead. Yeah, you've been waiting on this
I
topic.
have.
But as Kia, it's true that the woman can see some areas that we are so
Yeah, bro.
blind to.
Yeah, bro.
Yes.
Yeah.
They see it, and then we bring it when they bring it to our attention. We tell them, I didn't see
What
that.
you talking
And
about?
every woman is not insecure. Your wife is not insecure. She can see.
Yeah, she's
Yeah.
discerning. I guess that's true. That's very, very true. That's true.
Well,
That's very true.
y'all know I watch a lot of TV.
You do.
And so this is this particular show I watch. And so one day the men were trying to tell this other man that a man in the group was not his friend. And so they had this party, and that man called this man who was not there to say, "Your wife is at this party, and what was going on?" Okay. And so when they tried to tell him that this man was not his friend, he says, "He's a good friend of mine. What's wrong with him? I don't see nothing wrong with him. He gives me good advice, but then yet he would leave and go home and throw that man's name into the conversation with the wife."
With the wife.
And the wife was like, "If you come and say Derek's name one more time, we're gonna have a problem up in this house." But he was still blind. He was still blind. With all the facts that were presented to him, he still wanted to accept that fourth party mess that was given to him by that friend, so-called friend that he take advice from.
Well,
Mm.
let me ask y'all a question.
When you find a man like that, and I guess I shouldn't say a man, because a woman could be like that as well. She can come home talking about what Sheila said. And I mean, what do you think the makeup? I'm asking y'all as men now,
Okay.
what do you think the makeup of that man is that he would take the word of another man and come home and go back and forth with his wife that, "No, you got it all wrong. He this, he that."
So I'll tell you, I thought of two things quickly. The first thing is, men naturally, we don't let people in. Right. And so when you finally get a good brother that you deem to be a friend, you're protective. And to the point, protective to blind loyalty. Right. You don't want to see what everybody else is seeing because, you finally let this person in and you only want to see the good of that person and not realizing that person is the bad is, which is your blind spot, is hurting you in a major way. I think the second thing for us is, I think we have a hero syndrome that is unisex, right? It's not just us trying to say women. I think also is men. Like we love that. And there are some people who, again, as I said earlier, they're not happy about you being happy. And if you're not careful, they will maneuver themselves right up next to you. Remember this now: a leech is only successful if he can attach himself to you,
That's correct.
right? I can't suck you dry unless I'm attached to you. And as men, by the time we realize we're being sucked dry, it's usually too late because we have been ignoring every other sign and condition whatsoever. And I think there's something in us that we just don't want to see things, or we feel like me, my mistake has always been, it's never gonna happen to me, right? Everybody else has been taken advantage of by this person. And I ain't gonna do that to me. And then when it happened to you, she'd be like, I tried to tell you.
Shame on you for not thinking.
Or that.
But I think that's so prevalent with men.
Yes, it is.
Like you said, we think it won't happen to us, mm-hmm. or it cannot happen.
Can that happen? No, you can't.
And before we know it, we've been bamboozled, mm-hmm. and it's brought to our attention, and sometimes we still don't want to accept the
fact. We don't want to accept it
that we've been bamboozled.
Everybody else is wrong.
Right.
This one person is right.
Yeah.
Yeah. We don't want to accept it.
So how do we correct this when your spouse sees your point of view that their friend is toxic?
Ooh. Well, I'll jump in now that I want you to respond to it. Mine said something that was key earlier that I think is so important when she asked the question, then why then did you marry me, right? I think we have to remind ourselves as men why it is that we marry this woman that we marry, because it's not just sexual, right? There's something about this person, especially if they're your best friend, that you know, and remind yourself, she's never going to purposely do me harm. My well-being is utmost important to my wife. So there's something she's saying. And I'll leave with this, brothers. Even if she's wrong at the end of the day, that's a risk worth taking when it comes to your spouse.
Amen. Mm-hmm. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Well, you said everything.
Well, listen, I'll add to that for you, because I believe there's one thing that we all have to keep in mind. We are to cover each other.
That's so good.
And
my
so when it comes down to our character, who can we really entrust?
My goodness.
To cover our character.
That's good.
Is it your spouse? Mm-mm-mm. Or is it your dog?
Mm-mm-mm. That's good.
Because right there. Your dog can get out there, yes, and put your name in the street.
And call
man,
you.
Yeah, I was with him. I was with her. And she said and she did. Yeah. Nobody is going to cover your character.
My goodness.
That's good.
Like a spouse. Amen. Amen. That's good.
And that's the bottom line.
Woo. That's it right there.
That is.
I'm coming with another question. What kind of problems do you see in a marriage when one spouse feels that her husband or wife values their friends more than they value the relationship with the spouse?
We got a problem.
We do.
Mm-hmm. We're going to stay in disagreement.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And why don't you pack your bags and go over and live with them?
Eventually pack their bags.
Right.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah. I will say to the men out there who are listening, this is your reality. Let me give you a stern warning. You can't sex this problem away.
So, ooh, Jesus.
Uh-oh. Well, watch out then.
Right. We don't like facing the friction, the problem. And so I don't care how good the sex is, you can't sex it away. You got to deal with this. You got to face this and what it is. You got to deal with this. You got to come to a resolve, because if not, you're going to look up. The old saying is, don't miss a good thing until it's gone. You're going to realize, I done messed this thing up and I can't get it back. And that friend who's been giving you all this counsel, when you now by yourself, they ain't going to want you living with them either.
That's right.
Right. You got to be careful of that. That's good. That's
Amen.
Good.
Yeah.
I'll just say, end it this way. Problems will develop, mm-hmm. in the marriage, especially if it becomes clear to you and your spouse that you are more loyal to your friend,
mm-hmm.
than you are to them.
My goodness.
If you find yourself squabbling with your partner about a friendship, you need to come to an agreement about how this friendship fits into your life.
Mm-hmm.
As we discussed earlier, you may need to set boundaries with your friends and let them know that you can no longer tolerate this destructive behavior from it.
Well, y'all know where we at. We are at that part of the day. And as we close, we are going to let you know how you can get in contact with us. You can inbox us on Facebook, Danny and Rhoda Whitfield, or Marriage Takes Work. You can email us at marriagetakeswork2016@gmail.com. Now do us a favor and share this broadcast with your friends, married and single. remember to turn to each other and not on each other. With that being said, we would like to give a special thank you to Elder Darrick and First Lady Takiya McGhee for joining us here on Marriage Takes Work. And remind you, our listening and viewing audience, to stay the course and be blessed. Hey there, everyone. This is Rhoda Whitfield. Have you downloaded the Hallelujah 95.3 app? If not, go to your app store and do it today. We don't want you to miss not one segment coming your way. We hope you receive some helpful nuggets today to apply to your marriage. Joining us next week will be Elder Gerald and First Lady Sharon McGill. So set your alarm to join us then as we dive into another Marriage Takes Work topic. Bye for now. Until next week.
Thank you for tuning in today. If you wish to contact us, inbox us at Marriage Takes Work on Facebook.
And don't forget to join us next week, same time, for another segment of Marriage Takes Work. Remember to love hard
and work your marriage.